Hello engineers, in this video we are going to discuss about the obvious symptoms of cavitation in centrifugal pump. Before this video we have made some videos about the cavitation, and in our last video we discussed about the what is cavitation in centrifugal pump, means how cavitation occurs in centrifugal pump. We discussed about it, where cavitation occurs in the centrifugal pump, what is the relation between the cavitation and vapor pressure, that we discussed in our previous video. And before that we discussed about the where could be the cavitation occurs apart from the centrifugal pump, where could be the cavitation can also be occurs, and what is the reason behind it, like in wall, in orifice, in the pipeline, that we also discussed about it, right? And before that we discussed about the cavitation phenomena, what is the science behind the cavitation, that we also discussed, right? And in this video we will discuss about the obvious symptoms of cavitation in centrifugal pump. So let's start the video. Before that, if you haven't watched that video, so you can also watch that videos in the centrifugal pump playlist so that your concept will be much better. So the first reason of cavitation in centrifugal pump could be your noise and vibration from the centrifugal pump, right? See here, this is your centrifugal pump. Now if you see, this is my centrifugal pump and this is the graph of the cavitation. This one is the graph of the cavitation, right? So as the cavitation will occur, what is basically cavitation? Cavitation is the formation of the bubbles, then collapsing of dead bubbles. As the bubble collapse, so what will happen, that as the vapor bubbles form, so what will happen after that? There is the formation of the vapor bubbles, right? And the force will be applied here. I have already told you about it, then it will be collapsed, okay? And as it will be collapsed, so liquid will fill, or liquid will replace this space, okay? But the velocity of the liquid which will replace this position or this space, which is very very high. So what happens, that as it happens frequently, so it simply strike at the surface of the pump. As it strike at the surface of the pump, so what happens, that at that time there is the noise occurs, right? Or you can simply say the vibration. But if there is the noise is coming, then you can simply say that now the cavitation is at its peak, means there is the extreme cavitation now occurring. Got it my points? Means if there is the noise is coming from the centrifugal pump, then this is the extreme cavitation. Got it my point? Right? So if you see the noise and vibration from the centrifugal pump, now you have to check the other parameters as well, means other symptoms you have to also check it out. Now what are the other symptoms? Now the second symptoms is volumetric flow rate will unevenly change. Okay, what is it means? It means that, let's see, what is Q? Q is equal to area into velocity, right? Your area for the pump is constant, okay? Area is constant. Now as there is the bubble formation is there because of the cavitation, so what will happen, that as the bubble will form, so it will reduce the area, right? As it will reduce the area, so your volumetric flow rate will be reduced, okay? Now as it collapse, so what will happen, now area will be available to flow the liquid, area will be available to flow the liquid. Now what will happen, that this Q will be increased, as simple as that, means as the bubble will form, so your Q will be reduced, and as this bubble will collapse, so what will happen, that this Q will be increased, okay? That's why I have written here volumetric flow rate will unevenly change. This is very very important symptoms which you must see if you have the doubt that there is the cavitation, okay? Now the next symptom is ampere will be unevenly changed. Okay, how it could be happen, means how could ampere will be unevenly changed? So see here, what is the power for the centrifugal pump? The power is rho q g h by your efficiency, right? So in the second symptoms we discussed that your Q will be erratically low, means your Q will be unevenly changed. So simply, you can simply say that as your Q will be unevenly changed, so your power will also be unevenly changed. Right? Very, very simple or logical answer. So your ampere will also unevenly change. So you have to also see the ampere as well from the LCS. Okay, so what is the next symptoms? The next symptom is that discharge pressure will unevenly change. Okay, so here you can see that this is my discharge PG. Right now it is showing the 10 kg per centimeter square. Now if you know the formula, that is delta P is equal to rho G H. So you can simply see here, if there will be the formation of the vapors and we know that the density of the vapor is low as compared to the liquid, that we know. So what will happen, that this delta P will be low, means it will be also unevenly changed. Okay, first it will increase, then it will be decreased, then it will be increased, then it will be decreased, increase and decrease, it will happen like that, right? So what you have to see here, 10 kg per centimeter square. So during the cavitation, what will happen? It will go like that, 4 to 7 or 4 to 8 like that. Okay, can you let me in the comments box what will happen if this discharge pressure will show like 15 kg or 12 to 15 kg? Now what could be the reason? Will this reason will be also comes under the cavitation, or there may be the some other reason? Please let me in the comments box. Right now, the last symptom which you have to also check it out, that is the suction pressure will unevenly change. Now how it will be unevenly change? Very simple is, there is the, you can say that suction PG. Now as this vapor bubble is occurring, so what will happen, that this pressure, means pressure at the eye, will be also increase and decrease. Okay, so what will happen, that so there will be the impact at the suction side as well, means your suction side pressure and your discharge side pressure will be unevenly changed because of the formation of the bubbles and then collapsing of that bubbles, right? If there is the doubt for the cavitation and you have to go in the field and you have to check it out, so you must have to check it out all these five symptoms. Okay, the first symptom is that noise and vibration, the second symptom is that volumetric flow rate, then ampere, then discharge and suction pressure. Okay, so you have to must check it out. Right now, please let me in the comments box, what will you do if there is the cavitation is going on, or if there is the cavitation occurs in the centrifugal pump? Now what are the prevention which you will take right now? Let me in the comments box. Okay, so that's all for the today's video. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning.